offshore nature sanctuary allows for a safe space to make memories. It is vibrant, it is living, and it is a place I have made my own memories at since being in the world. It is far from dead, it is far from unloved or uncared for. As you can see, we are here today not to restore the land, and we aren't here protesting about pollution in space. We aren't here talking about crime or violence in the nature sanctuary. We are here celebrating life. South Shore residents, businesses, stewards, nonprofits, educators, and entrepreneurs, and us, the youth. Because I have been taught to understand the living system that sustains Chicago's economy, I appreciate Chicago balancing how our nature, urban nature, and spaces can make money. Environmental education is so important. It is my hopes to continue learning about nature in our city and help our community understand what wealth we have in healthy nature on the south side of Chicago.
That is in some way exclusive against African Americans. I'm a golfer. My children were a part of the first tee program. I absolutely love all things outdoors. I have a problem with managed lands using fertilizers and pesticides so close to our fresh water. I also have a problem with understanding the barriers of a sport like golf, because while children in Chicago golf for free until the age of 17, really it isn't the cost that's prohibitive. Have you ever tried to play 9 rounds of golf and work 2 jobs? It's not the cost, then it becomes the time. So we are time poor as well as economically poor and educationally disinvested in. We are just behind the eight ball all the time. So what it is that I wish for my elected officials is, number one, the Environmentalists of Color is here as a group of interdisciplinary scientists and professionals across the range, whether that's people in water, people in air, people in soil, people in conservation. Before you speak about a natural area, if you need information, please, 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 we are here to serve you with information and data that can support mindful and knowledgeable policies. Before we advocate for something that we think is a positive, or we fail to advocate for it fully, so that the community can benefit both economically as well as environmentally. I am so very happy to see so many people out here celebrating the monarch. It is an organism that has connected the city and connected the city with other countries and other places. And I hope it's a reflection of how it is that we can move forward. This is not to call out any specific elected official saying that you're wrong for wanting economic development. We absolutely do. We realize that Chicago's environment is used to leverage to draw in tourists as well as other opportunities. Miami on the Beach is a perfect example of how it is. The city invites people and we have contracts and then there's conflict. And shout out to everybody that was protecting the birds and for Chicago Park District doing the right thing. And even Miami on the Beach understanding that this is a dynamic system. What we wish is that elected officials, as well as our Chicago Park District leaders, work in connection, in combination with local leaders, community stakeholders, as well as community professionals, in order to have a very vital and economically equitable South Shore. So thank you so very much, and if you have any questions, be more than happy to answer them. Snaps. Yes.
You may have already spoken on this, but what's the connection between the stresses, physical, mental, emotional stresses that powerful psychiatrist has written much about, and the connection to having access to places like the wilderness and